Hey guys, James FC Reviews here. Well, I just woke up after screaming into my pillow for 3 hours after recording the Worst of 2019 video. And now that my head has stopped hurting and I'm a little more calm, I've decided, why not talk about the best movies of 2019? Because there were some really phenomenal movies that came out this year. And you know what? Let's just shine some light on those. Like I said in my Worst of 2019 video, these are not the scientifically accurate best movies of 2019. This is my personal list. Your list may be different than my list. Feel free to leave your list down in the comments. I'm very curious of what you guys have to say. On top of that, there were plenty of movies that came out this year that I did not get a chance to see. So if you guys are wondering, why, where is this movie? Why isn't this movie on here? I probably haven't seen it. Much like last time, before we go into the main list, we're going to talk about some honorable mentions. These are the movies where if I was doing a top 15 list, then these would make the cut. But I'm not, so these were the ones that were still really enjoyable, but weren't good enough to push over the edge and make it onto the main list. How to Train Your Dragon 3. This has been the most consistent series by DreamWorks Animation, and it wraps up beautifully with this film. Ready or Not, underrated horror comedy with a great sense of humor, great atmosphere, cinematography, editing, and a hilarious ending. Dora and the Lost City of Gold. No, I am not kidding. This movie is genuinely one of the funniest things I've seen this year. I would highly recommend going to see it. Peanut Butter Falcon, one of Shia LaBeouf's best performances. Really hope this gets attention at the awards. Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. Yeah, it drags in places, but it's still really entertaining, it has good performances, and that ending is one of the most epic things I've ever seen. So, those are the honorable mentions. Let's get started with number 10. Number 10. Frozen 2. Yeah, I'm just as surprised as you are. I was not a fan of the first movie, and although the trailers looked promising, I still went in with very lowered expectations. And after I watched it, I had to see it again. Yeah, it's got some problems, like the opening is a bit rushed, Kristoff's subplot is kind of uninteresting, Olaf is still very annoying, and the ending is a bit of a cop-out, but everything else beyond that is great. The story, the animation, the action, the characters, the music, everything was amped up to 11 in this movie. Normally, I'm an advocate for leave good enough alone and don't try to force a sequel, but honestly, part of me is kind of curious what they could do with a Frozen 3, especially if it's done as well as this. I may still hate the first movie, but I can't wait to revisit this one and have a blast going into the unknown.
Is the whole putting us in mortal danger gonna be a regular thing?
Number 9. Alita Battle Angel. Why did no one go see this movie? Seriously, why did no one go see this movie? This movie was absolutely amazing, but no one saw it. The visuals were breathtaking and extremely close to the OVA, the characters were all likable and interesting, the story was intriguing, the action was so amazing, over the top, and badass. It was just such a fun movie. In a world full of shitty live-action anime adaptation, this got probably as close to perfection as you could get. I know the movie underperformed, which is a shame, but I really hope we get a sequel to this. It sets itself up so perfectly for one, and the world is so cool, I would love to revisit it. If you haven't checked out this movie yet, I would highly recommend it. You won't be disappointed. Number 8. Us. I wasn't exactly sure how to feel about this movie when I first saw it, but after subsequent viewings, I gained a greater level of respect for it. Yeah, the ending is kind of a mess, and how it goes way too exposition heavy and loses itself in the message, but everything else in the movie is really solid. The cinematography and editing is well done, the score is absolutely chilling, the cast, especially Lupita Nyong'o, playing both herself and the Tethered, is exceptional. The directing, the writing, its seamless mix of suspense and comedy, everything comes together to make a really great movie. I'm really excited to see what Jordan Peele does next.
Be careful.
Number 7. John Wick Chapter 3, Parabellum. There is a good chance that I will revisit this movie next year as part of some John Wick retrospective, because this movie, as well as this series, manages to keep a consistent level of quality that makes each entry absolutely entertaining as hell. There are a few slow moments and certain segments feel side questy, but the story overall is much more engaging than the second, the action is exhilarating, the creative and brutal ways we see John Wick kill people is both awesome and hilarious, the acting and stunt work by Keanu Reeves is ridiculous, seriously, that dude is a literal god. The rest of the cast do great work, the cinematography and editing is beautiful, and it's just a non-stop blast from beginning to end. I know there's gonna come a time where the John Wick movies will have lost their charm and there's gonna be too many of them, but that time hasn't come yet, and I'm incredibly excited for John Wick 4 whenever that comes out. Definitely one hell of a good time.
What do you need? Guns. Lots of guns.
Number 6. Ford v Ferrari. I have never wanted to make love to a car until I saw this movie. This film is fucking gorgeous. The cinematography is so well done, particularly in the racing scenes. I saw this in advance as part of the Chicago Film Festival, and the DP was there doing a Q&A. That dude is gonna get an Oscar, mark my words. But it doesn't stop there. The performances from Christian Bale and Matt Damon are great, they have killer chemistry, the writing is on point, the story is gripping, the drama felt genuine, and there are several exciting clincher moments. The only thing I didn't really like was the ending, but that's not really the movie's fault, it's history's fault. Still, it just kinda left you on a sour note as you were leaving the theater, and I didn't really like that. But it's so small and everything else is so great that it's hard to stay mad at. This was a great time at the theater, and if you haven't seen it, you absolutely should.
If this were a beauty pageant, we just lost.
Looks aren't everything.
Number 5. Rocket Man. A lot of people compared this film to Bohemian Rhapsody, and not without reason. They both share a lot of similar elements, they even share the same director, kind of. But personally, I think Rocket Man is better. The story is more interesting, the conflicts and drama are more gripping, the characters are all likable, which makes it all the more upsetting when bad things start happening. The performances are flawless, especially from Taron Egerton, and the music and visuals are absolutely stunning. This isn't just a glorified concert movie like Bohemian, this is a proper musical. They use these iconic Elton John songs to move the story forward and convey what the characters are feeling, right down to having the characters themselves break out into song. And the visuals during these sequences are so vibrant, flashy, and creative. It really helps establish the fanciful world the movie sets itself in. What more can I say? One of the most badass rock stars gets one of the most badass movies.
My gift is my song, yeah. This one's for you.
Number 4. Marriage Story. This was another movie I saw as part of the Chicago Film Festival, and it was both beautiful and incredibly depressing. This film showcases a real, relatable scenario of a messy divorce, and it is just as stressful as you can imagine. As someone that comes from separated parents, there were several scenes in this movie that hit very close to home. But what makes the drama even more compelling is the fact that neither the husband nor the wife are really in the wrong. It would be so easy to paint one side as the villain and the other side as the hero, but no, both these individuals have done some fucked up things. they're both still human. Hell, the couple aren't even the ones initiating a lot of the conflict most of the time. It's the outside forces like best friends, family members, and lawyers that are making the situation more difficult than it needs to be. On top of that, we have Oscar-worthy performances from both Adam Driver and Scarlett Johansson, a well-written script that has some lighthearted moments that don't feel forced, and like I said, a really gripping and compelling story. The movie is currently on Netflix, so if you haven't seen it yet, please do yourself a favor and go watch it. You won't be disappointed.
Eventually, it'll be the two of you having to figure this out. Together.
Number 3. Jojo Rabbit. Oh boy, prepare for World War II in the comment section, am I right? I know a lot of people are split on this movie, but personally, I thought it was brilliant. Its ability to balance hilarious comedy and gripping drama has to be commended. It's ridiculous, over the top, and self-aware, but over time, it starts to become more grounded and suspenseful. It's written in such a way where you can have imaginary Hitler diving out a window in one scene, and then an intense Gestapo investigation in the next, and the transition between the two isn't jarring. The characters are written phenomenally well too, which makes it all the more heartbreaking when bad things do happen to them. The performances all around are fantastic, the cinematography and editing go from bright, quirky, and lighthearted to dark and gritty seamlessly. And it's just such a satisfying movie overall. I feel like a lot of people that got angry at this movie missed the point entirely. The movie doesn't come from a place of hatred, and at no point is it sending the wrong messages. If it did, then there wouldn't be so many serious or tragic scenes. If you are one of those people, I strongly advise you to give the movie a second chance. Who knows, you might find that it's actually better than you thought. Or it'll just piss you off even more. Either way, for me, this was definitely a major cinematic highlight this year.
Nothing makes sense anymore.
Yeah, I know, it's definitely not a good time to be a Nazi.
Number 2. Avengers Endgame. Up until 2 months ago, I was convinced that this would be number one. But then in October, a certain movie came dancing down the stairs and knocked the Avengers out of the top spot. But even still, absolutely no discredit to the movie at all, because my god. I saw this movie 6 times in theaters, and I found myself enjoying it more and more after each viewing. Yes, there are some scenes that drag. Yes, the time travel shit makes no sense. Yes, there are a myriad of plot holes, but none of these aspects ruined the movie for me. The story was a seamless continuation from Infinity War. The drama felt genuine as we see how the destruction of half the universe has affected these characters. Although the movie does go into darker places, it still doesn't forget that it's a Marvel movie and keeps the same sense of humor, and for the most part, it works. It's well paced out to where it doesn't feel like 3 hours have gone by, but at the same time, nothing feels rushed. The second act is full of fan service that is just an absolute love letter to MCU fans. And the third act, Jesus Christ. Never before have I seen a climax quite like this in a movie. It's so exhilarating and action heavy. Part of you doesn't want it to end, but even when it does, you still feel satisfied. And although everything after does go a bit Return of the King, it's still well-earned and emotionally effective. There's a reason this film surpassed Avatar as the highest-grossing movie of all time. This was more than just a movie. It was an event. It was the perfect finale to this 22-part saga and capped off 11 years of storytelling wonderfully. So much heart and soul was put into this movie, from the writing, the directing, the effects, the music, and of course, the absolutely stellar cast, putting in 110%. People can say whatever they want about the Marvel movies, good or bad, but you can't deny the impact the MCU has had on pop culture. And for a movie like this to garner so much attention and success has to be commended. And yes, while there will still continue to be MCU movies into the far future, bringing in new characters and storylines, this movie served as a perfect send-off for the original team of heroes. And no matter the placement on this list, I will always love this movie, and this series, 3000.
And I am Iron Man.
And the number 2019 is... Joker. Now I don't feel as bad about putting Endgame in my number two. Joker is literally a perfect movie. I've had a decent amount of time to let the movie sit, and I can't think of a single flaw with it. This film is so great. Its story is super engaging because, much like the Joker's before him, it's multiple choice. There's no definitive direction the story goes, and with how crazy the Joker is and how he imagines things, it leaves a lot up to interpretation of what's really happening and what's in his head. It's super tough to watch, especially when you see how Arthur is portrayed. He's shown as a guy who has a serious mental illness, but is still a good guy with no ill intentions. It just took several kicks to the dick by society to turn him into the murderous psychopath that we all know. And Joaquin Phoenix sells every minute of it. You go from liking him, to feeling sorry for him, to being fucking terrified of him. You're constantly stressed every time he's on screen because you can't predict what's gonna happen. The rest of the cast do great. Zazie Beetz and Robert De Niro both have small roles, but they still leave a great impact. The directing by Todd Phillips is fantastic, the cinematography is masterful, the score is chilling, and the film's themes and subject matter are absolutely nerve-wracking. The film shines a realistic light on mental illness, depression, and suicide. Issues that no modern comic book movie would dare touch upon. In fact, this doesn't even feel like a modern comic book movie. It's low budget, it's a slow burn, there are no big action sequences or sky portals or any of that shit. It's just as Joker himself said. It's just the story of a mentally ill loner crossed with a society that abandoned him and treated him like trash. And what do you get when you put those two together? The best goddamn movie of 2019.
When you bring me out, can you introduce me as Joker?
And there you go, those are my top 10 favorite movies of 2019. Like I said, these are just my picks. Feel free to leave yours down in the comments. I'm very curious to see what you guys have to say. And before I go, I just want to give one more super heartfelt thank you to everyone who has been watching me over this past year, who has supported me both online or personally. It really means a lot that so many of you guys have followed me and, you know, like what I'm doing. And, you know, I really wouldn't be doing what I'm doing and sharing my passions with you guys if you weren't there to watch them. So, seriously, thank you guys so much. And another thing is, there are going to be some big changes going into this new year. YouTube itself is going through a big and really scary change that you guys have probably heard about with this whole COPPA situation. And, you know, I don't really know what to do about it except, you know, being honest, like, with how I set my videos and stuff like that. But regardless of what happens and or how big the effect is, I'm still going to try my best to put out, you know, good quality content for you guys to watch and enjoy. And like I said, just continue doing what I love and sharing my passions with you guys. So as long as y'all are there to watch it, I'll just keep chugging away into the new year. So once again, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you all had a happy holidays, and I hope you have a very, very happy new year. Here's to 2020 and all of the good and bad that it will bring. Until next time, be sure to like, subscribe, ring the notification bell so you can stay up to date on what I'm posting. Follow me on all my social media, subscribe to my main channel. Everything you need to know will be in the description. Thank you guys for watching. See you later.